Community, my dudes, welcome to today's Let's Play of Super Robot Wars the Moon Dweller. Today we're tackling part 12. Or was it 11? I wouldn't be able to recall. Regardless, let's get nuts. Also, joining me today for this shitpost of a Let's Play, we're gonna have. Do you guys want to be named or you want to present yourself?
You can name me.
Alright. We're gonna have It's a Gundam and Double No Fail to join us.
Hello.
Or I could see, I believe it is Falchion and a oh wow. This is how bad I am, guys, with your names. Why do you do this to me?
You can just call me Lehman. It's fine.
Thank you, Lehman. You make my life so easy now.
Just call me Gundam.
Alright, Gundam. Oriwa Gundam. Where's the. Well, here's an old option. Lehman. Like to be here.
Yeah.
Alright. So. We're going to be tackling episode 36, for anyone that's wondering. The fuck is this? Well, 36 mission out of 47. Spoiler.
I wasn't going to ever play this anyways.
Perfect, because I'm skipping all the story bits anyway, so we'll be skipping to the good part pretty quick. So, just making sure my team 4 mission is on point. It's not. You go here.
Wait. Question. Yep. I don't know if you do. You guys know the like the Vanguard series?
Guard 5 Vanguard?
No, I mean like there's an anime called like Vanguard or something like that.
What?
It was like an anime called Vanguard. It was a mech anime or something like that. I can't remember.
It would make sense, but I don't know of it.
Let me see if I can find a picture. I'll put it in Discord.
By all means, go ahead, dude. I'm benching you guys to the abyss of the bottom of my screen. Alright, that makes sense. So, for those new to this game, don't know how it works. It has not always been like that, my dudes. But in this game, you can basically team up characters together. Then you can give those mechs and characters special abilities secure together. That's the thing you see at the bottom. Increased beam damage, increased range of damage, increased evasion rate, increased hit rate. Helps a bit when you're gonna fight some very strong enemies that have high odds of hitting you and cannot be hit. Sounds stupid, but it can be hell. And then there's their own growth level when you level up in points, and then you can pump your bank. This is basically a numbers game. You can make a select few of your pilot completely busted if you so wish it. I didn't do it! Yet.
I'm terrible at math.
It was called Van Dredd.
Oh,
Van Dredd. I know that, kind of.
Is that Robot War?
No, if Van Dredd was ever in Super Robot Wars, I'm not the man to ask. I would need my resident expert, Bao. Unfortunately, the real Bao is not available right now. He's probably half dead coming back from work. So, for those wondering, have any of you ever seen Stargates?
No.
Not particularly.
Again, then imagine the following. Again, connecting multiple dimensions together and no real frontier border to limit that thing.
Kind of like that, what was that one game? The one game that was with, like, all the Capcom and...
Capcom versus Marvel?
No. There's, like a Final Fantasy style, like...
Yeah.
White Knight Chronicles?
What? Say it again?
On 3DS?
Yeah. It was on 3DS, yeah.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're thinking about. I just forgot what the name was. Yeah, that's a good example of it, you could say. Project Cross Zone.
Yeah, there we go.
I know that. I know what that is.
It's a good way to put it. Alright, so that's gonna go here. Now let's move, my dudes. Rule of the game is pretty simple. You're given one simple objective at the end, at the beginning of every mission. Kill everything! Usually your defeat comes at the defeat of your battleships. Makes sense. SR point is an extra objective you can fulfill, gain yourself some free goodies for everybody. It makes the game harder the more you have.
Excellent.
So we're gonna try and dab it. Right now it's still random, that's just because that usually means not everything that's gonna be on the map is on the map yet. Be careful. Well, I'm sort of over level right now because I don't use the maximum amount of dudes, so let's just go nuts. Do those ladies happen to have... Nope, they cannot move faster. So, outside of having your mech, which has a select amount of weapon, which is basically your skills, it has spirit commands, which are basically pilot's special ability. Right now I'm using Quicken to basically cover more ground per turn. Not everybody has it, but those that have it, you can be sure I'm gonna bloody use it. Abusively. Up you go.
Question, is there a US release of this game? Or a Super Reward game?
Yes, there are, but they're on Game Boy Advance, as far as I'm concerned. You have OG1 and OG2.
Oh.
Which are not bad games by any stretch of the imagination, I have to say. They're not as fabulous as that one, I'm playing, which, might I stress, is in full English. You can see everything in English right now. I'm not hiding it from you. You have every stats, pilot ability, mech ability, weapon info. You can go to the description if you want to. And when your character starts to speak, let's say, do I have, if I go to sell Grantine? Should be on... can I find Grantine's special ability, Larcelium, to give you guys an ex... There we go! Oh, it doesn't say it. Well, here's another thing this game features. When the characters are going to be bringing a past event or an important word, it's going to be highlighted in blue. You can actually pause the game, press the touchpad button on the PS4, and then it's going to give you an entry about that. It explains you the event, if it's a past event, it tells you the weapon or the item if it's a past, well, thing. And those descriptions will have blue words for you to click on and then just scroll back and scroll back and scroll back and learn more about what you've missed.
So it's an in-game wiki walk.
What?
So it's an in-game wiki walk, basically.
Yes!
Give me more of that.
For God's sakes.
Well, at the very least, it gives you an option to know what the fuck happened, Desu.
True.
Alright, so you're about to see a battle scene here. That's when I met myself and my characters already busted. Opponent's chance of hitting me, 0 and 10%. My chance of slamming them in the face with a revolving bunker, 100%. What could go wrong? Oh, and I'm not kidding, that's really what's gonna happen here. Every character can have their own separate team. I changed some of them because I didn't like them. What you're here right now is the real team of Arier called Flicker and Geist, I believe. Or Patchwork Ghost, if you want to know your German. I don't know by it, I just know that one.
Oh wow, jiggle physics.
Yes, well, oh, it is. I will have you know that they have that Gynax bounce. Like every RPG at the end of this, you have your experience gained, your PP received, PP is used to buff your characters. Literally, it is points you put in their stats for raw stat gain.
So which place? Is this your first playthrough of this, or no?
Definitely, no. This is my fifth playthrough.
Oh god.
At first, because this is basically an OG remake, because the first time they have, I guess that's not how I should put it, Super Robot War J, that's a fan translated game on the Game Boy Advance, Judgment. This is where the protagonist of this game first appeared. This is where the aliens in this game first appear. The Fury, not to be pronounced the Furry. We shall purge the furry field. The god and putter of mankind has spoken. Exterminatus has been invoked. Nah, not those guys. The Fury, which are basically space hobos.
The best kind of hobos.
I'll tell you what, dude, they're gonna get off my goddamn lawn!
What lawn? You're a hobo!
No, you don't get it, dude. The lawn is my... the lawn. The earth is my lawn, and they shall get the fuck out of it.
Oh, well, now when you say it like that, that makes sense.
So...
sidestep.
Yep. Dude, I can sidestep a battleship the size of the moon in this game. Size be damned. By the way, that makes for some very fun combo with the current logout in Z.
So it's false. Bigger is not always better.
Indeed.
I mean, we've seen that multiple times in Gundam series. Just say.
Yep. Also, these games usually have Gundams in them. Well, the non-OG game. That's what I wanted to say earlier. When they first introduced the characters of this game, the main character, the main aliens, it was a non-OG game. So you had characters from the Mazinger series. You had characters from Tekamon, if you guys, or Technomon in the US, if you know it that way. You had characters from the Fullmetal Panic. Love those guys.
Still, I wanna watch it. Is it good?
Fullmetal Panic is pretty damn good. You had characters from I forgot what it was. The full name. Martian something. The Diesco.
Martian successor. And the
there
Diesco.
We go. You had a bunch of series slacked up together. Also, you want to see a classical super robot doing your rocket punch? You're gonna be served. I give you the Jewel Dynamic Guardian. Sega, the Cleaver of Evil. And of course, Rain Face Maker.
Ah, these
or Ratzel, for sure. Look at this guy. Also, you have to be wary of those two, because they are the one that spawned the memes that real men rides each other to the sunset of battle. I'll make that a picture later, promise. Also, if some of the English makes you cringe, don't feel too bad. There's a bit of English in there, but at the very least, we get the gist of what they want to say pretty clearly. Also, I have a question for you guys. Gundam. Looking at you, dude. Do you like maids?
Yeah, I guess.
Well, there you go.
Ah, God.
He's like, why did you do this to me? These Mustang's final attack is actually a live concert show where they stab the opponent to death multiple times with Tonfa blades. Not cool.
Why me? Why, Maid? Why?
Welcome to Super Robot Wars, where this type of shit happens from game to game.
All I knew about were the Not Gundams, the Huck Beans.
Yeah. Well, you're gonna see a Gundam-like suit right now, actually. That's one of the things that I want to reproduce soon. I'm probably gonna end up using something like the Justice backpack for that. Maybe Goodyear's Jack Doga head?
I think you got enough beams there.
You can always have more beams.
In this map, I will unlock a character that likes to chuck dark holes the same way I chuck candies at children.
Wait,
you like to chuck the fuck?
Let's see here. What's actually badass to show for y'all? Oh! How about I can't show it yet. There's a character in my team that basically has more things equipped than a meteor and the freedom together.
I am concerned.
You should be. I am still surprised it doesn't detonate like a mother when it gets hit by a stray round. If somebody's wondering.
I am very afraid.
Also, this is the first time I see actual blade bits being attached to a rifle, but I don't dislike it, I must say. They might look chibi, the suits, right now, but it needs to be said that when you do their ultimate attack, they take their real form.
Wait, Tara, she has a gun that shoots knives?
Yeah, they're basically fangs.
Knife.
I'm
about
bringing a knife to a gunfight.
Knife. Gun. Knife gun.
It's actually a gunsta blade. It's what it's called, guys. I'm not picking it up.
You know what game I wish it would make a remake for on PS4? Zone of the Enders.
Oh, God. I wish there was another Zone of the Enders coming.
It was actually explained why there's not one. It happened way back on the PS3. By the way, part of the answer is Konami's a dick. Just so you know, but,
of course it is.
Isn't it because there was, like, not enough funding for the game? Why didn't you just do a Kickstarter?
Here's what they did. They released the, remake version of Zone of the Ender.
Oh, yeah, I didn't sell a lot, right? Or something like
that. Yeah, that's
the
one of the problems.
Had problems.
Didn't get enough.
Not enough released, but what they were saying is that they would develop Zone of the Ender 3 or something like that. If they sold enough. Now guess what dickery they pulled. Let's not produce enough to meet the quota.
Yeah, that's about what I thought. God damn it, Konami.
Wasn't that a Kojima game? That was made by Kojima, right?
Yeah, that was also made by Kojima. That's probably one of the reasons they wanted to spite him so bad.
Yep, that is our favorite Kojima.
Bye-bye.
So after Dead Standing, he should make a Zone of the Enders type game. That'd be dope.
completely selfless and cheap plug. I made that mech in GB3.
Did you?
Yep. Single line. That's what What I've been doing on my off time is basically a replica tutorial where I replicate unit from the Super Robot Wars OG into a game. Trying to make it fun desire for people to learn to just have fun with.
Well, Zone of the Enders was in that game?
Can you repeat that?
Wait, so Zone of the Enders was in that game? Like, Mike's from Zone of the Enders, like...
I wish Zone of the Enders wasn't Super Robot Wars, and it would fit right in. It's not. It never was, and I wish it was.
Because who wouldn't want to see what is it? Isn't it the Anubis? Something like that?
Any of the orbital frames would be great to see.
Anubis, Jehuti, Vig Viper, I forgot the one that's used by the girl in the second one. But yeah, no, they were all super fun to watch and see.
Nethis was using the first one or something like that.
Is that about the crazy female pilot?
Yeah, the crazy one, not Ken.
This is not crazy.
Well, to be fair, she is crazy.
She's a bit on the cray-cray side. Alright, so what you're about to see here is the protagonist, and her level of attack and destruction is not to be taken as everybody's level of fuckery.
Oh, hi, Calvina.
Yay. You play Judgment?
No, but I... Well, that's one of the few characters I do sort of know.
Alright. Right now she's past her... The Switch is no longer that bitch. But for the sake of the...
Why did she... Wait, question. Why did she have the V2, like, arms?
A V2 what?
Like, you know, the Gundam... The Victory Gundam... The 2... Burst or something like that?
Oh, why is she... What does she look like? A Victory 2 Assault Buster?
Yeah.
You could say that she's basically... She's actually pulling a Gurren Lagann right now.
She's piloting a mech that's inside of a bigger mech, isn't it? Isn't she?
Yep, that's exactly what's happening.
Oh! Alright.
When I do my ultimate, you'll see exactly what I mean.
She can just curve beams now?
Yep.
Yep. Dynamic kill animation. Gonna love them. Just a laser. Asha! You missed!
This is a mook horror show here.
My apologies if I can't be that entertaining, but dude.
Question.
Answer.
From C. What was that one? Was it the Chaos Gundam that could bend beams?
From C, would that be a Chaos Gundam? What?
One of the, like, I forget which mech. From, like, the Seeds or, like, Seed and Seed Destiny. One of the Gundams could bend beams. If I remember correctly.
That is a possibility. Yes, just a bit.
It was like green.
They're forbidden.
Yeah, I think that's... Is that the one with the scythe, right?
Yeah, the forbidden was the one with the scythe that could bend beams.
Yeah. Oh.
And whose transformation was just putting its backpack on top of its head.
Well, to be fair, it sort of made sense.
Well, it worked.
Yeah. I mean, it basically made it more armored.
Did they ever? I'm sorry.
Go ahead, dude.
Oh, did they ever explain why it could bend beams? Or is it like, it just can do it?
I think they simply said that he was generating some sort of electromagnetic
colloid
field, something like that?
It says colloid. It's colloid particles.
Oh, there you
go. Geschmeidig Panzer uses colloid particles to repel and redirect energy beams.
Well, did you word the Minovsky particle of Seed, so sort of makes sense.
Yeah. What doesn't make sense, why don't the Sabres have it, but, yeah.
Is what?
You know how, like, usually in gun series, beam sabers, you have, it's like, whatever type, whatever they're using, there's like a coating around it to make it have the beam shape, and they, that's why they can clash. In Seed, that doesn't happen.
Oh, yeah, they can't clash in Seed.
That's why you always met with a shield.
That's why they, that's technically why they had anti-ship swords or something.
You would think that, but no, anti-ship swords do not have that deep coating. That's why...
It'll go right through.
Yeah.
That's just weird.
That's basically what happened to Shin in Destiny, like... He got dicked.
He did. He's like, what?
Then what's the point of having that?
There's none! That's how bad the Surrey was!
It's just a regular beam saber with a big block of nothing behind it.
Exactly! If they had at least given the blade anti-beam coating, you would have been able to juke it out. It would have made sense. It was basically a good way to parry beam sabers. But because for some reason they decided to use a prototype design of the Freedom from way back the inception of Gundam Seed, well, no development was made, no new equipment was found outside of what was on the Impulse, and that thing was supposed to be the buff to the Impulse. End result? Trash.
Trash.
Throw it to the garbage, for it is today's garbage day!
It's trash, Gundam. Alright, I'm done.
Sorry, but dude.
No, I'm the one taking it too far.
You don't have to take it. Dude, it was alright! You're between friends here. Worst case scenario, also, the only one they're gonna be that's gonna be taking the heat here from the seed bashing is me. That's a guarantee.
Also, one thing I never understood about the anti-ship swords: why do they have the giant block that's like right under the blade part
that gets stuck in ships?
Yeah,
I get the feeling you and I watch a similar guy way
Oliver
back then.
Didn't have. Like, I never understood that. Like, the Excalibur completely fine, because his just goes right through.
Yeah, but the Excalibur can coat itself completely in the laser.
Yeah, but it, like, then why didn't it... But it went backwards to for the Destiny Gundam.
Yeah.
That's the problem, like, how do you take a step back?
I mean, then they go back to, like, the Destiny was their original plans for... some sort of freedom-like Gundam, and they didn't change the design when they brought it back.
Oh, by the way, you're about to see the mech come out of the bigger mech.
So, like, the end of Gormagon?
Yep. And then it's gonna use the bigger mech as a bigger gun.
What?
Yeah, I'm warning you. Somebody's about to die.
Well then.
Well then, indeed.
Oh yeah.
I just want to point out that looks like a war, but on its own, not what they did in it. Like,
do you please repeat the name of this game? Super Robot War.
Oh, and it's not just a laser, it's a crystal laser.
Yes, hey, then we're going to shoot a laser that will bounce on all the crystal particle and murder whatever's inside.
Also, gain axing.
Yes, plenty of. This is the protagonist suit, good sir. If it's not completely busted, you're doing it wrong.
Well, there's plenty of things being busted around here.
Come on, wasn't that the crystal from the 00 movie?
Nah, I will. Allow me to reassure you, the crystal thing has been a thing of this, of these protagonists ever since the GB era. It's just how it works. The mech powers itself by absorbing particle called Orgon, which tends to crystallize when left in midair. So when you hit somebody with a huge concentration of the thing, you create crystallized formation. That's basically their excuse. Boop, boop. I hope this is a good show for you guys so far.
Well, it's crazy.
Was it the Super Robot Wars where there was, like, the God Gundam versus, like, or sorry, the God Finger versus the Shin Finger? Like, on the opening scene?
Yeah.
Wouldn't the God Finger just go right through?
Mind you, I'm pretty sure the God Gundam's spreading finger is just gonna tore through Shin's.
Yeah.
Shin doesn't care about logic.
I'm pretty sure, like, that whole... His whole organization doesn't care about logic. Let's just throw this thing on a Gundam, just because...
He uses a particle...
You know, the problem you see is we're actually short-range beam cannons.
He uses a beam cannon for a melee attack.
What could go wrong? I'll tell you right now, everything.
See, it would make sense if it was like a pile bunker. Like, just boom. Done.
Whoops. You know what? Just make it a beam pile bunker. Why not?
There we go. There we go. So you mean a beam saber in his hand?
Yeah, now you don't have to worry about beam sabers not being able to clash.
I mean, right? it's not like the unicorn had a thing called the beam tunfa.
But wasn't that just beam sabers on its wrist?
Well, yeah, that's basically what it was, but you could use that way. Also, lasers.
Well, yeah, it's the unicorn.
Oof. Speaking of the unicorn, I still don't know why we have the third unit of the unicorn called Phoenix. I mean, yeah.
Because money.
I guess. I don't see the label, I guess.
You know, it showed up in the animation they made after after Reconquista was done. They made a small animation, and the Phoenix shows up there for whatever reason, piloted by the masked figure from the show, except now it's painted silver.
What? Full frontal pilot?
No, it's from Reconquista, it's Mask, that guy.
I am lost on so many degrees.
Sorry.
Also, you guys are about to see something completely fabulous. I am warning you, this upcoming battle, there's going to be something that's going to get totally overkilled and somehow thrown back onto the earth before being tucked out of the atmosphere.
Wait, isn't that the thing from Rogue One? The shield thing? That's what it looks like.
It's nuts. Just trust me, you're about to see something completely nuts. Real men ride themselves unto the victory. Like the God of War!
Oh, God. Or, oh, God of War, I guess.
Yes!
You know, this is pretty entertaining to watch.
It is completely nuts and I love it. Iki to send! Just got the guy.
I'm gonna sound like a real scrub. But I feel like it would be pretty cool if they had, like, a Super Robot Wars Mushu game.
I wish, dude. I would be so down for that.
That would be insane.
But it would be perfect for the genre.
Insane, but perfect.
Did she see self-destruct sequence after Data Transfer? I am pretty sure there's nothing left of you.
No, the pilot was Kira. He's still alive. Or it's still alive.
Two of them, and my attack only covers one of them. I did something completely. Oh yeah, I'm about to show you maids going cray cray. Hope you're ready.
It's level up.
It's the only time I'll show them. Promise.
Oh god, here we go.
Here goes. Okay. Ah, man. Wig system is basically shifting all the controls to one person while the other person just have foresight. I mean, it sort of makes sense, but what they do with it.
Oh, God.
Oh, you're dying inside a bit?
I wasn't already.
Well, you're about to taste the rainbow now, sucker.
Ah, Jesus.
No, you don't get it, dude. It gets worse. It's not over yet.
Oh, please. This is going absolutely... Sudden... What?
Taste the rainbow, motherfucker!
Did they just have a magical girl sequence? Did that just happen?
What was that?
Did they just have a magical girl sequence? Apparently, yeah.
Unable to continue combat. Yeah, I feel you.
Unable to continue combat. Why, good sir? I've seen some shit.
So how long does it usually take you to beat this game?
How long does it take me to beat this game?
Yeah, like on average.
If I was to be on an average, not showing every attack, which, let's face it, takes about 45 seconds a round, and there's a lot of round per turn, honestly, I think I could finish this game in 14 hour to 20 hour. If you want to have fun, read the story, watch the attack, you can easily double to triple that time.
I found I was talking about Reconquista NG from the past to the future. It was a short film, and the Phoenix shows up as being recreated by the Capital Army. I know, that still doesn't make any sense, but
yeah.
I should just stop talking.
Oh no! Wait. It's interesting in its own cathartic way. So you can continue.
Nah, that's just not going anywhere. I'd rather go back to this insanity.
Welcome to my world.
Is Seed and Seed Destiny the only Cosmic Era series?
Anime wise, yeah. All right. Manga-wise, you have Astray, all the Astrays.
You have the Librarian Work Conflict as well, which basically, I think, is the last thing that happens timeline-wise, because the Seed movie never came out. Thank the Lord.
Thank you, whatever stopped that from coming to existence.
Wait, so then what is Dub Below?
I forgot what era is Double O, but it's a standalone series.
Anno Domini.
Thank you.
Which is AD, our time, I think.
The only what the fuck I really have with Double O, because I could do a lot of suspensions of belief in the series, it was well paced. My only what the fuck was how do you make orbital elevator with our planet rotating at the insane speed. I forgot the actual number. I mean, wouldn't the thing just fucking break off in the atmosphere completely?
Unless it really reconstructed itself like every like 3 seconds.
Like what?
Like it had like nano lamp, like nano bites, just like reconstructing itself and just keep on doing it and keep on doing it and keep on doing it.
Oh, I get you, yeah. Though the amount of resources it's gonna cost over the year, don't forget, it's something that stretched out in the atmosphere.
It would have been I swear there was one way to make it work, though I may be confusing that for other things like orbital tethers.
Yeah, that's what I'm about to say. The way I could see this work, you have the tower reaching up towards a certain height, and after that, it's basically a tether, a huge strong cable that's flexible. That could work. No?
I mean, essentially, you just have a cable with a counterweight at the top.
Yeah. And coming out of the atmosphere, then you'd have huge, neck-large, fucking massive solar paddle. And there you go.
Yep, that could work.
Alright, and for those wondering, like, what the fuck just happened? As I said, this game basically links to another dimension, and timeline-wise, they decided to do, hey, we have those games happening on the side, and those casts know each other pretty well. How about we have the cast meet? I mean, it's not the first time they meet anyway. So they basically gave us the most OP suit of all. It is nuts.
Oh no.
I will be chucking dark holes left and right like it's nobody's business.
My concern has grown again.
If it's worth it, the character is an alchemist and it's totally rooted in reality.
All right, you're throwing black holes. How is that grounded in reality?
Trust me, it's more grounded in reality than when I do the Big Bang.
Wait, what?
More of that later in the show, Super Robot Wars OG, the Moon Saga. We fucking wrecked the galaxy.
So, kind of what Gurren Lagann did? A lot of people died.
More like what the Anti-Spiral did.
Oh no. A lot of people died of that series.
By the way, the one time Gurren Lagann was in this show, the final boss were the Anti-Spiral.
The amount of casualties of Gurren Lagann at the end of the series.
I don't think I can imagine a number high enough.
Right.
You're chucking galaxies at each other like it's nobody's business.
Right, it's like, oh, this is just a rock, just throw it.
Shurikens? Why the fuck not? Hide behind one while you snipe the other fucker? Sure.
Oh, hey, this is a suspiciously familiar blue planet. I think I'll sculpt this into a butter knife.
Oh, man.
Not to mention, they were standing on a galaxy. Yeah. Like,
our galaxy. What?
Well, that must have been an interesting sight for the astronomers in that galaxy.
Like, everything we know, just throw it out the window, guys. Just throw it out the window. We need to restart.
I think someone just stepped on something near us.
Oh god. Thousands and thousands of years of evolution dashed in a moment.
I think Alpha Centauri's gone.
I'm not gonna shed a tear for it.
Wait, so technically didn't Simo, well, not technically, didn't he become the Spiral King?
Simo? Like,
of all the universes?
At the end, I thought he simply retired.
I mean, but like, Anti-Spirals, they're pretty much like, they're like the Spiral Kings of like all the universes. If you beat one, wouldn't that make you?
Like, oh, right, I get you. I guess that's the seat they didn't take that seat that way. Yeah, I'll give you the point. However, other universes that have now been freed that were at a similar level to Earth, not as high but similar, are now, well, pretty much free to go everywhere they want. You have other races evolving that are, I think, receiving helps from Earth. It's gonna, if they were to make a sequel to Gurren Lagann, it'd be a hodgepodge.
I mean, it wouldn't, but you could. It's funny because, like, you can say, like, the movie ending and then the show ending are both canon because of the multiverse theory thing.
Dude, you could tell me that they can drill a whole true reality, and I would believe you.
Yes, all the galaxies are free, especially the ones that got thrown and then missed. They're way free of everything, spiraling off into infinite darkness.
Can we talk about those two galaxies that were smashed in by the anti-spiral to create the Big Bang?
Yeah.
Oh, for God's sakes. There's also other things
going on. Angel, imagine a guy's like, finally, I just retired. Time to go take this trip, and it's gone. Everything is gone.
Yep.
By the way, I think there's some things happening on screen, but
Rap Attack.
Galaxies. Just galaxies.
Wait, isn't the final version of Gurren, isn't like Interplanetary Galactic Tangentopa Gurren Lagann or something like that?
Yeah. That's basically what it is. Let's see, I'm gonna go with Rag. Oh, there's only one dude left? Goodbye.
Well, you're screwed, buddy.
Yeah, pretty much. Alright, we're gonna do it again. Goodbye. Now we're gonna show you guys code EDN. Keep in mind, I'm about to fucking attack a mothership. You're about to see an example of size doesn't matter.
I mean, if you take a Gengar and Lagan.
Let me nail that shit up.
It's a lot of missiles.
Once again, this is a battleship that's probably a few kilometers long.
Wait, time out.
Oh, God.
Did his arm get ripped off?
Did he just throw? Did he just throw it? And she caught it. And now it's on his horn. And now he's flying up. And there it goes, a stake through it. And oh god, now he's shooting a bunch of bouncing balls.
Lasers for everybody. That's my example of you can body everything in this game, and it's just beautiful.
I'd like to know how the crew survived that.
I think that most of the crew is actually made up of robots.
I'd like to know how they aren't pulped in the circuits.
A great question. Shall I make it worse? I show you guys the Wild Worker and Vector Break. How is it gonna body a ship bigger than itself by shedding its armor? Let's go, Maggot! Do I guess
I didn't know it would just shed armor like that? Not
holy sh! What the?
The ship's not dead. What is this ship made out of?
it's using the defend command, which cuts its damage by like 60%. So I'm not doing that much.
You just pierced straight through and then exploded.
Aww. It's all good, I'm still here.
It's alright, guys, I got HP left.
That's basically it. But you were thrown into three new dimensions and still the Lord of Hell. Yeah, I know. Still alive, though.
Yeah, just look at my status bar. I got tons of health.
I'm gonna save you guys out of the mission because it's gonna go nowhere, so... Boom, boom, dead. Goodbye.
I guess you guys would tell me this. What exactly is frame arms?
Frame arms, I don't think there's any specific show for them. They're just toys being made. And to be honest with you, I wish they had a show, or I wish they could be used in Super Robot Wars, because their designs are neat. But as far as I'm concerned, they're all toys.
I always want to get one, but they're kind of on the expensive side. They are on the expensive side.
Oh, the ship is almost dead. We're making progress, guys. Motherfuckers are after my lady. No, get off the waifu.
Never touch a man's waifu.
Yeah, this game is full of waifu. I mean, that's a waifu couple right there. Well, waifu couple, that's a husband and waifu. Combo. This is gonna do the thing. Yeah, it's doing the thing. Look at this, guys.
Oh, hey, that guy's got a unique unit, I think.
Oh, it is neat.
Is it a spider? I feel like it's a spider. I hate spiders.
Did he just create a white hole or something?
No, it did create a black hole.
I think it looked like a quasar.
But black holes suck in things and white holes spit them out.
Alright, I'm about to show you guys what I said that was more weapon packed in one package. I'm gonna go further. It's more weapon than all of Seed combined put into one mecha that, to be fair, is a bigger version of the Dendrobium statement.
I will reserve judgment until the animation is finished.
Well, is fetish a good term, good sir?
I have this odd feeling all those blades are just gonna come off.
She went over 11, by the way.
Who gives these people this much power?
This is the fourth story in an ongoing scenario. That was a end of the that's a counter end of the world weapon. As for the
other, is she done? I don't think she's done.
No, if she hits, it's gonna go on. As for Glassies, well, she's just an alien from a race that likes to genocide everything.
Well, that's very approachable.
I hope you're ready to rave, guys, because we're charging the Neutron Busters.
Talking about funnels.
Neutron Buster, let's go, motherfuck!
Wait, this thing's supposed to cause the world to end?
This is a character out of the world. Those are mechs they got at the end of a game, where they were trying to prevent the end of the world.
Oh, okay.
But that's why they have busted toys like that. So I'm gonna spare you this animation a second time, because that's what it takes forever.
Okay, the only thing I noted there was something called the Rave Laser. I focused on that.
Understandable.
Because everything else is just
a lie.
What is life?
It's hilarious, I told you. That ought to be enough for a while. Focus.
Change. Hilarious? This is terrifying.
It makes for a great game, though.
I will not contest that, but it's still horrifying.
Could you imagine the guy who's like, hey, Captain, we have a lot of crap coming our way. So what do you mean? Just look outside the window. He's like, oh, that's what you mean.
That wasn't like, part of the job description.
I want a raise now.
Well, how's our HP? Well, how's our HP going on, sign? pretty good, sir. Then don't worry about it. Go back to work.
Oh, 2 turns later. That's why they don't need a complaint department. That's about the one of the closest thing to a gun that I can find.
What was that one show? Well, I think it was Made by Sunrise also.
This?
It was about, like...
Dokrum?
No. It was... Oh, what was it? Can't remember the name. It was like, it was about like a kid who went to like another world or something like that. And then got a mech. Like, I just like spent like every like.
You know, I'm sort of. I want to say Escaflowne, but I don't think that's Escaflowne at all.
I think I'm a. Wait, yeah. Hold on, let me check.
Escaflowne is a medieval mech.
Oh, it was. It came out, like, in the last, like, 3 to 4 years. Like, the main character, he has, like, brown hair, and then, like, the other main character has blonde hair. Like, his mech's red, and the other mech's blue ish.
Aldenoa Zero
is not bad at all. And I wish it was in this game. Maybe in the future.
No, it wasn't that. It was...
I don't know.
I'll find it. So... Also, I don't know if you guys follow, like, the Evangelion stuff.
A bit, yes, what I can.
A little.
When is 4.44 coming out?
That's a good question.
3.0 plus 1.0. If that's what it's called. Official.
Well, fun fact, the Evangelion is being rolled in the upcoming Super Robot War Voyage.
Oh, really?
Yes.
It'll come out whenever Anno stops trolling his fans.
Well, the game I'm speaking about is coming out on the 23rd of February.
Well, maybe he'll have gotten sick of trolling his fan base by then.
Or maybe he ran out of funds again. That
also a possibility.
It's like, he's like, man, You think after the first time it happened, I would have learned? Nah.
Hey, I can tell him it's coming out, and then I'll run out of budget, and it'll never come out.
Guys, we're gonna do this in marker again.
If he just decided to gain a fraction of the funds he could make with the hentais of this, or anybody that did hentai and this stuff, there you go. He'd have funds for the next 15 years. Though with the rate of production he has, that might be enough to cover 2 stories.
I would not want to see what will come out of that.
Oh, well, we all know where it's gonna go. It's gonna be a bunch of ray clones, like enough to fill a fucking screen into the one dude, maybe. Or they're all gonna jump on Asuka. That could be interesting. Or maybe Mary's gonna get them all, then you're gonna have to run for Mary.
You know, also didn't get, like, in the third movie, they're all mad at Shinji. Shinji obviously doesn't know what's going on. Obviously asked, hey, yeah, what happened? And they're all so mad at him. Like,
that's one thing. I mean, I can understand why they're so mad pissed, but they should have at the very least explained to him.
And when you call the third impact,
explain in Evangelion? What are you talking about?
Well, here's the problem. Because they didn't explain the shit to him, and he's such a gullible little fucker.
Caused the fourth impact.
He caused it? He did. I thought he was able to stop his fuckery.
In the.
With his two spears.
The third movie? Because, what's his name?
3.2 with that. I only know the French name, Tabris. I don't know his actual English name.
Kaoru?
I think I remember reading Kaoru.
Yeah, his head explodes when they're in Ava Unit 10.
Yeah, because he tries to stop CG from,
Ava 13, they had those collars on them that would kill them.
Yeah.
Actually,
and then
I believe that was put out by Misato because Misato wanted to stop him from, doing something stupid.
And they did it anyway.
God damn it, Shinji, you got into Robot too well, and now everything's gonna go ass up again.
The worst part is that Kaoru sort of warned him, like, to stop it, those are the wrong spears, shit's not right, and Shinji just didn't listen.
And wait, didn't he destroy Lilith at the end of the third one?
I don't know, it wasn't clear to me. I don't know if he destroyed Lilith or finished the fourth impact. Because from what I read, the fourth impact was only partially successful.
Well, the world would never know until the fourth.
We only have whatever the hell the preview for the at the end of 3.0 was, and that showed two halves of Ava Unit slapped together.
Yeah. Fighting the mass-produced Avas, right? No. Was he fighting the mass-produced Avas?
I think they're called something else, but essentially I think they're supposed to be like that.
Aren't they like, I thought they were like, I think their official numbers like 7 or something like that? I don't remember the numbers. I know 1, 2, 0, 4, 5, which are practically the same thing. One's silver, the other's blue.
4 was freaky as shit, if that's the black one that was spotted by CG's friend.
Yeah.
No, they're apparently called the Mass Production Evangelions, so they don't seem to match the actual.
Well, no, it makes sense. It's, they're essentially coming from a Jubi's left testicle, after all. The source of testicle that gets rid of all the universe.
I just wonder how messed up that is to make your son get into his mother.
Unbirthed fetish, let's go.
Everything's Freudian these days.
Like,
well, I mean, Gendo did earn.
What's Ava Unit 1? Your mother, get in it. What? Just doesn't explain the rest.
Meet your giant robot purple mom.
And you're about to ride in her womb.
Oh yeah, she's gonna almost die a lot, like her arm's gonna get cut off quite a bit. Might get just, I don't know.
Then she's gonna get really pissed.
Yeah.
Try not to freak out when she tries to hug you, by the way.
By the way, I think that German girl's also riding her giant red mother.
What about Ray? She is.
I think she's riding herself.
Yeah. It was like, oh, she's a clone of your mother, which she's a clone of the Eva, which, long story short, she's riding herself.
Nope, this is like your Tatsu Kaya.
Then who the hell is Mary riding?
I don't know what that got.
To be honest, when we put it this way, this is one of the best mindfuckery they ever could think about. I've yet to hear of something even worse than that. Not saying it's bad, but holy shit. That depression you were having, dude.
Also, I should never understood, how does Mary pilot Ava Unit 2?
How does who pilot 2?
Mary, whatever her name is.
Oh yeah, Mary Illustrious Mikami. There's actually a manga that explains it. Do you know how Kaoru is from... Kaoru knows about all the times the Earth was resetted.
Mm-hmm.
He has conscious memories of the previous loops.
Isn't he like supposed to be like Adam and then raise Eve?
It is by, like... a possibility that I could foresee, yes. But he does say at one point before going onto Earth to stop Shinji, well, to try and stop Shinji from completing the fourth impact, like, well, it's that shit again. Like, literally, it's deja vu all over again for him.
And, I like how, like, they show him on the moon, and then, like, that's the last time you see of him in the second movie. That's it.
And that's basically what he speaks about, like, oh, well, here we go again. Like, I would be surprised if Kaoru had now his very own plans away from the seal. But he always had that, usually just suicides. Because he can't escape the seal's control.
Seriously, who the hell is Mary?
I was about to get onto that. Mary is basically the same as Kaoru, and she was, that's gonna come out as awkward. She was Seiji's lesbian lover.
You're right, that did come out weird.
But, at the time, Seiji's mother was like, no, I want to go out with Jendo and Kerry. And then shit happened. And somehow, I don't know the whole story, but I can link you the book. She survives. She makes it out of the Earth resetting itself multiple times, and she keeps her memory, and right now she's trying to prevent...
Isn't there, like...
What?
You finish.
She's trying to prevent the whole events that occurred in Earth time to happen again, I think?
Like... Isn't there, like, a theory where it's, like, the movies and the show are all, like, so the end of the show, like, you know, like, when they, Asuka and Shinji are standing, like, the last two humans on Earth, it's not like a soft reset, and then that's when the movie starts?
That's
why the water's red.
That's the idea, yes. Every time you saw a movie or a serial, whatever. It's basically the continuation of the series of time loop. It's what happens after.
God, and I thought I actually had half a handle on Evangelion, but as it turns out, no, I don't!
We all think we do, and then we read more into it, we were like, what the fuck? Also, guys, I'm about to use a black hole buster cannon. Hope you like it.
Oh, God.
Fuck the laws of physics.
Yeah.
If you're just wondering what the fuck is the green thing, that's psychic powers.
Oh, that's good.
This gun can.
Where the hell did that come from?
Oh, where the gods come from? Oh, she simply calls it from the universe.
Oh, of course.
She has that kind of power. Wait, I'm so confused. If all these people have this kind of power, why do you need a team?
God.
For a serious answer, she probably simply requested from the battleship.
And that didn't... That didn't even do that much.
Well, he's a boss, you idiot.
How can you survive that many black holes?
I don't know. Ask the anti-spiral.
He's named Godmodka, and if you modify his name a bit, you have Godmodka. Godmodkai.
Did say God. Something Kai, or God. God. Something God again.
Actually, God, the version damn it. Of the God. Yeah, here's one. God damn it.
Right. Like, I don't know if you guys watch like any like Dragon Ball Z abridged.
A bit of it. I'm not all that versed into it.
Oh, I watched it.
Like they just recently did the Broly movie, and it was like it was North Kai talking to South Kai because Broly destroyed like the whole South Galaxy. And the adversaries, and then he's like, oh god, it's all gone. Oh god. And he's like, South Kai, it'll be okay. He's like, I know who did it. It was my ex, man. She said she was gonna get me. And, and then, like, Brawly's like, I wonder who destroyed South Galaxy. Like, I bet. Because Brawly, he's like, it's your parallel to everyone, pretty much. Well, Goku and Vegeta. And he's like, yeah, mine's pretty high. And then Goku's like, I wonder who destroyed South Galaxy. And then Brawly's like, I bet it was someone with a very high power level.
Totally not me.
Yeah.
Sort of just casually throwing off his power level.
By the way, how's Brawly in DBZ, Super DBZ? Was he done right?
Technically, Brawly's not canon.
We just have another legendary Super Saiyan, apparently.
Yeah, apparently there's another legendary.
And a female, no less.
Yeah. Which, so Brawly, his original idea, for Brawly was a female Super Saiyan. But at the time when they were going to make that movie, it was, I forget her name. She was like destroying Goku and like everything. She was pretty much destroying everyone. And Goku like got punches her into the sun. So originally it was, Brawly was supposed to be a female, but.
They felt bad about at the time.
Yeah. So apparently now it's okay. I don't understand.
We have equality.
Everyone gets to get punched. When equality, now equality.
But I kind of get why, because before the Z Fighters didn't have a female person to fight with them, but now they have 18. So I guess.
They better not use 18 to fight off Brawly.
I bet. That's what I'm saying. Like, I swear to God, bro, 18 better not win.
I mean, as far as I'm concerned, she gets swatted lightly and her hand flies off.
Yeah.
18 is powerful. 18 is powerful, but not that powerful.
Like, or they could have Boo fight her, which would make sense. Because Boo's technically not a male or a female.
Although he did technically apparently make a lady boo at some points.
I want Vegeta to stop it there and say, woman, on your knee, and just do his thing.
And then he gets kicked in the stomach.
Actually, no, I was thinking more about SNM plays, but yeah, that too. That awkward silence. Now, about that Gunsta Blader I spoke about. Oh, Spirit, yes. Let's see, we're gonna go with... Focus, Instinct, Most Needed. Fate, Focus.
But it was also weird because, so like in the, like, Dragon Ball Z, like, the Vegeta airing fusion was it. So in Super, they made it so 30 minutes to go up, go along with the Gogeta transformation, which is 30 minutes, which I did not like. I was kind of upset about that.
I can sort of see why. Gogeta is a super fun character to watch.
Why change Vegito to 30 minutes when it was infinite because of the Pator earrings?
Well, we never did. Well, I guess we never did see Gogeta for that period of time in that point, but I don't know. I'm just going to call it. They wanted to change it because they didn't want to have to go through the trouble of either separating them again or just saying, oh, yeah, now Vegito's the main character.
And then you would have two wives.
Yeah. Which, it's funny because, like, so with Super, it makes a multiverse theory canon.
Yeah.
So all the movies
are canon.
And GT is canon. But not canon? Which is, it throws me all off. They need to explain it somehow.
They get to decide which one is canon and which one got completely butt-fucked by Goku Black. There you go.
It's canon when we want it to be, and when it's not, get out of my house.
So now I have to ask you a question. Which universe is the one where Mr. Popo is the evil ruler of the universe?
All of them.
It just knows better, bitch.
Which, it's funny, because like now I'm super, like... having a tournament to destroy universe. The losers, their universes are destroyed. How is that okay?
Well, we already did it. It's called Bokurano.
Like, what?
I agree with that.
Let's just pick kids, put them in a giant robot, and say, oh, hey, if you lose, your universe dies.
Dog Beetle was totally the basic for Jubei.
Like... and it's funny how, like, with the way the Omni King looks, because he looks like this plushy toy.
He looks like he's a blue. He looks like he's a pill for him.
Yeah, it's weird. And the fact that he was so casual about saying, yeah, I destroyed. There was, like, what? I think 12 other planets or 12 other galaxies before you. Now there's only 7 or something like that. No, it was 14. You destroyed 2. Just casual. Just destroy universes.
This guy is just nuts. Alright, so as promised, they're gonna put you through that attack again.
Also, apparently, if you go by, like, the way Super Saiyan is, Super Saiyan 4 is as strong as Super Saiyan God Goku.
Super Saiyan what, Goku?
So, Super Saiyan 4 is as strong as Super Saiyan God Goku. If you go by the way this, like, so Goku, or Super Saiyan is times 2, and then Super Saiyan 2 is times 2 of whatever Super Saiyan was, and then just keeps on going.
Mm-hmm.
So, technically, Super Saiyan 4 is stronger than Super Saiyan God. Which doesn't make sense, because God is in the name.
Well,
if you understand that for them, God is not as much the omni-being as much as it's simply a state of being. You're powerful enough to be considered an unstoppable force.
Touché.
Super Saiyan 4 may have more power, but that it doesn't. But Super Saiyan God has God Key, so.
Yeah.
I simply see them as administrators, not as divine beings, if you will.
Also, I never understood the Kais. What's the point of having a Kai if you have an Omni King?
Sort of like a king has retainers, I guess. I don't know.
Also,
to not have the king basically have to bend over for every galaxy every 5 seconds to see if everything goes well, I guess?
If you're an Omni King, I feel like you have that power, like initially, like, you know, like, it's not even a thought, you're just, alright, I see whatever, what's going on. Time for me to make someone who's gonna do something.
Maybe it's just they're in the nature to delegate. I don't know.
What makes sense?
But then, like, if there's a Kai, then what's the point of having the gods of destruction, and then if on top of that, the angels that monitor the gods of destruction? Like, I understand the hierarchy thing, but I feel like you only need two.
I have a feeling somewhere in this, someone will give the answer, I got bored.
Or it could be like what happened with Trunks. Like, because you know why Trunks doesn't have a tail? Because he forgot it. He forgot Saiyans had tails. And Gohan had a tail.
What?
Yeah, he was like, I forgot Saiyans.
I'm glad he didn't forget that they had hearts.
Alright guys, I got a question for you. Do I use an attack called Distorian Break or Black Hole Cluster?
Historian Break?
Okay.
Whatever, I mean, sure, Distortion Break, that sounds lovely.
I had both. Skipped, my bad. Well, I'm gonna do it over again.
Why not both?
Is it powerful enough for both? Alright, so I'm gonna do two things here. First, you need to die. Organized
question.
Thank you. Yep.
In this game, are there if you have two mechs together, can they combine to make one mech?
Yep.
Oh, that's cool.
Or you can have them combine already, but when you deploy them, to save yourself the time. Well, there's a 3% combine.
The guy has dragons and a. Is that a wolf head? I'm so confused. What's happening? The guy. Is that a wolf's head on his chest?
Dragon,
rock the dragon.
Yep.
Gaia, throw breaker!
By the way, this is totally not a reference to the Stardust Memory.
Oh yeah, that lingering shot isn't familiar.
Alright, that fucker is dead. Thank you.
Wait, time out. Is that a beam saber or was that a whip? I'm so confused.
It's a beam saber. He's just going too fast.
He was already dead. He was already dead when you tried to slash him. Let him die.
All right. So Distorted Break. There you go, guys. This thing is nuts.
It's kind of funny how, pilots just so like generic anime character? Like they look like generic anime characters just piloting like, you know, things that could destroy, I feel like could destroy universes own.
The mecha you're about to use can destroy universes.
Yeah, I would totally, what the heck? What's happening? I'm so confused. Which screen am I supposed to be watching?
You're about to see it happen. An attack that leaves space and time unstable.
He's not dead. Alright. Well then. You would think he would have more, like, cooler attacks, since he's taking all of this stuff.
Fair enough. Cooler attack you haven't seen yet. I think I've showed you about everyone.
I'm talking about, like, the boss you're fighting right now, like, come on, dude. Like, all he's doing is, like, grabbing people. He's doing shiny finger. That's all I've seen, really.
Yeah.
And shooting laser beams.
Well, I can show you one more thing. Did Bakahara? Yes. There we go. We went god mode. Let's go. Degenerative cannon. Asha. Of course, he's buffed to all hell. Strike instinct. Thank you.
You know what's also weird?
Huh?
Like, or not also weird, but like, things that don't make sense to me are in a series, Digimon. Like, God, Digimon and Digimon are like, OD. Like, how do you... Your data, and you can alter the real world? What?
More of that later, but basically, see it this way. Your whole being, your whole thought, everything you are and know, is basically electric current running through your brain. That could be digitalized to an extent. We could basically compute that to data. So you being data works. And then I don't recall the exact name of the tier or the whole damn spiel, but basically our memory, our consciousness, whatever, shows us how we perceive the world. So that's basically data that can be interpreted. So data can change the world. It's very badly explained, but I think that's the gist of it. Also, here's an apple for you.
They got real meta.
Well, you want to see real meta? Look at what's about to happen in the game.
What is that?
Hey, oh, when did you start me? The creation.
The almighty push? Sorry. He created a universe.
No, he didn't create it, trust me.
That didn't do that much damage. How are you still alive, sir?
Those characters don't have buffed stats, they're just bare I'm fighting an endgame boss with them. I'm just surprised they're not dead yet.
Wait, that implies that they just killed the pilot. What? So wait, if they were buffed, like, that would have killed them in one shot?
I would have done at least 3 times the amount of damage. And attacked twice instead of once.
Well then.
Speaking of that... Flickery Geist, Quicken, Veiler. Magnum Steak, yes, removing Bunker, and eating out of the end of it. Let's go with that.
You know, I'm kind of starting to get tired of, like, anime throwing around the god tag.
Anime throwing
what? Like the tag of I'm a god. It's like, take Naruto, for example.
Oh, the Messiah complex.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll
after
getcha.
A while, because, like, it's like, oh, yeah, I'm an all-powerful being, and I got beat by the power of friendship. What?
I can see why. Or, I can see how that would piss you off.
Alright, I'm back.
Welcome back.
I had to do some impromptu outside work. It's cold out.
Alright.
So, what are these stats that you're doing? Like the spider focus things.
Oh, the spider thing?
Like the inspire focus, or I kind of really can't get
skills?
Are they skills?
What?
Like when you're in like certain menus, it would say like focus. Oh my god.
Oh yeah, those were... Yeah, I guess I can explain that much. Those are the pilot skills. Focus gives you 50% chance... 50% more chance to hit, and 50% more chance to avoid. That's what I was using, so I could hit the guy proper. Veiler makes you hit 2 times as hard. It's stuff like that.
It's gonna change form. Oh, he runs.
What?
Wait, did he just run away?
He runs on you.
Well, for a godmother, he's not very.
Oh, he just wanted to. You just wanted to test the water. Also, he doesn't have a missile complex at all. Let that be known. He's a weapon merchant, and he enjoys war. That's about it.
One of those types.
And when there's a big conflict, well, he's basically looking for new technologies, you know, good offers. And then he lifts them off of you. And that's gonna be it for tonight's stream. I am tired, and from what I'm hearing in the background, you guys are dead. So, thanks a lot for being with me, guys. I hope you had a good time. And I'll be calling it for tonight.
Sorry, my headphone.
No problem, dude. I'm basically calling it tonight. So, meet you all tomorrow. I hope you had a good time. Wish you guys a good night. See, it sounds like you're dead as well.
Thanks for having me.
Dude, it's my pleasure. Whatever you want, wherever you want, let's meet. Tomorrow is going to be a bit more Gundam Breaker. I need to figure out how to make one more tutorial. After that, I'm probably going to be... doing one more quest of this game, Super Robot Wars OG, the Moon Dwellers, before finally tackling some Blaisloo. The order doesn't really matter, but that's pretty much my name. Let it dudes in. Have a good night.
Alright, see you.
Night. Iron Man, have a good night.
Yep.
You too.